Laudetur Jesus Christus, praised be Jesus Christ. A warm welcome to this live broadcast of the Holy Father Pope Francis Wednesday General Audience of 23 November. We're coming to you live from St. Peter's Square here in the Vatican. I'm Father Paul Samasumo, and I'll be providing you with the English language commentary for today's General Audience. Do allow me to first acknowledge our partner television and radio stations of Luminous Radio, Radio Maria Papua New Guinea, Radio Maria England, Catholic Faith Network in America, Shalom World TV, Salt and Light TV, Atmadashan TV, EWTN, and Catholic TV. To those who are following us on Vatican News website, YouTube, or on other social media channels, on shortwave radio, there's some radio stations. Welcome. If you are watching us on TV, then you are seeing right now Pope Francis making the rounds of St. Peter's Square in his Pope Mobile as he goes around greeting the crowds in the square who have come to this Wednesday General Audience. It has been a few days of rain and dropping temperatures here in Rome, but today it is a sunny morning in St. Peter's Square of the Vatican. Pope Francis continuing on his journey, greeting the pilgrims as he does often when he is in the square, and giving a lift to children there along coming on for a joy ride of a lifetime. Those of you who have been following Pope Francis's catechesis on Wednesday, the Pope has been teaching about discernment. We expect the Holy Father to continue with his teaching on discernment today. Who knows, the Pope may also make some reference to the visit he made over the weekend when he went to Asti. It's a small town located in the Piemonte region of northwestern Italy. It's about 55 kilometers from Turin. Pope Francis was visiting Asti, a place from which his grandparents, with his father, Mario Bergoglio, emigrated to Argentina in 1929. In fact, Pope Francis planned the visit to Asti in such a way that it coincided with the 90th birthday of Carla Rabezzana, who is his second cousin. After landing near Asti last Saturday, the Pope stopped to pray at a village church. Then he went straight to Rabezzana's house for lunch. It was a private and intimate family visit, and it was not open to the public. And after the lunch on Saturday, Pope Francis visited a nearby home for the aged, and he went to a village nearby also to visit yet another cousin called Delia Gai. The following day, 20th November, Sunday, was Feast of Christ the King, if you recall, with several of his cousins, their children, grandchildren present, Pope Francis celebrated Christ the King Feast Mass in the Asti Cathedral. It was really the only major public event of the weekend getaway. About 25,000 people, I think, are said to have attended the Mass, others no doubt following on large screens erected outside, because the Asti Cathedral can accommodate only 4,000 people. Pope Francis told the Asti congregation that the Christ the King allowed himself to be insulted and ridiculed so that whenever we are brought low, we too will never feel alone. Again, the Christ allowed himself to be stripped of his garments so that no one would ever feel stripped of his or her rightful dignity. At the end of the Christ the King Eucharist service, the Pope recited the Angelus. But just before the Mass in Asti, Pope Francis received honorary citizenship from the mayor of Asti, Maurizio Razzero. The mayor said the honorary citizenship conferred on Pope Francis was because of his strong commitment to peace in the world and his daily messages of solidarity and fraternity against all forms of discrimination, These, said the mayor of Asti, are also values that are enshrined in the statutes of the city of Asti. The Pope was given a small bag containing the soil of Asti. You could say the whole visit to, in Asti was really an opportunity to look back on his roots. Maybe he's going to make reference to that in today's audience. So back to what is happening here in the Piazza, the St. Peter's Square. The Pope is just finished making his rounds of the crowds, greeting the crowds, the pilgrims, and is now nearing the stage where he will begin the audience, where all the activities of the general audience take place. The general audience in St. Peter's Square is really an opportunity for pilgrims to visit with the successor of the Apostle of Peter, the successor of the Apostle Peter, and also to receive the apostolic blessing while in the city of Rome. The Wednesday general audience with the Pope consists of short teachings, the catechesis, and the scripture reading, mainly in Italian, but translated into English, French, German, Spanish, Polish, Portuguese, and Arabic. And during the audience, the Pope greets individual visitors, various pilgrims, groups in the square, each one in their language. At the end of the audience, the Holy Father recites together with us all the Our Father. The Our Father is usually sung, but sometimes it is recited. And to conclude the audience, the Holy Father imparts his apostolic blessing or papal blessing upon the pilgrims who are in the square. This blessing extends to loved ones that are sick and suffering. The Pope also blesses any religious articles such as rosary beads that the people have brought with them to the square for the purposes of blessings. And of course, that blessing that the Holy Father gives at the end of the audience extends to all of us watching or listening to this broadcast. When the general audience starts, the Pope will start with the sign of the cross, and then we will listen to the proclamation of the scripture reading. Today, the scripture reading is coming from Psalm 62. He alone is my rock and my safety, my stronghold, so that I stand unshaken. He alone is my rock, my safety, and my stronghold, so that I stand unwavering. Applause to the Holy Father as he approaches the seat on the stage where the audience will take place. As I was saying, after the proclamation of the readings, the Pope will give a brief teaching, the catechesis, and then that will be summaries of that catechesis will be made in Italian, in French, English, German, Spanish, Portuguese, Arabic, and Polish. And now the general audience is beginning. Let us compose ourselves to enter into the spirit of the moment.
Nel nome del Padre, del Figlio e dello Spirito Santo. La pace sia con voi.
There we go. The audience is now begin.
I fedeli di lingua italiana desiderano esprimerle filiale affetto e sincera fedeltà e pregano per tutte le intenzioni del suo universale ministero apostolico. A conclusione di questa udienza canteremo la preghiera del Padre Nostro in latino, terminata la quale il Santo Padre impartirà la benedizione apostolica che estende in modo speciale ai bambini, agli anziani e ai sofferenti. Dal Salmo 62.
So they're reading now from Psalm 62.
Solo in Dio riposa l'anima mia, da Lui la mia salvezza. Lui solo è mia roccia e mia salvezza, mia difesa, mai potrò vacillare. Solo in Dio riposa l'anima mia, da Lui la mia speranza. parola di Dio.
Psalm 62, read in Italian. The psalm reading will now be read in the various languages.
Du livre des psaumes. Je n'ai de repos qu'en Dieu seul. Mon salut vient de lui. Lui seul est mon rocher, mon salut, ma citadelle. Je suis inébranlable. Je n'ai mon repos qu'en Dieu seul. Oui, mon espoir vient de lui. Parole du Seigneur.
A reading from the Book of Psalms. In God alone is my soul at rest. My help comes from Him. He alone is my rock, my stronghold, my fortress. I stand firm. In God alone be at rest my soul, for my hope comes from Him. The word of the Lord.
Lesung aus dem Buch der Psalmen. Bei Gott allein wird ruhig meine Seele. Von ihm kommt mir Rettung. Er allein ist mein Fels und meine Rettung, meine Burg. Ich werde niemals wanken. Bei Gott allein werde ruhig meine Seele, denn von ihm kommt meine Hoffnung. Wort des lebendigen Gottes.
Lectura del libro de los Salmos. Solo en Dios descansa mi alma, de Él viene mi salvación. Solo Él es mi roca salvadora, Él es mi baluarte, nunca vacilaré. Solo en Dios descansa mi alma, de Él me viene la esperanza. Palabra de Dios.
Leitura do livro dos Salmos. Só em Deus descansa minha alma, dele vem a minha salvação. Só Ele é meu refúgio e minha salvação, a minha fortaleza, jamais serei abalado. Só em Deus descansa minha alma, dele vem a minha esperança. Palavra do Senhor.
قراءة من سفر المزامير. إلى الله وحده تطمئن نفسي ومن عنده خلاصي. هو وحده صخرتي وخلاصي، هو حصني فلا أتزعزع. إلى الله وحده اطمئني يا نفسي، فإن منه رجائي. كلام الرب.
Czytanie z Księgi Psalmów. Dusza moja spoczywa tylko w Bogu. Od Niego pochodzi moje zbawienie. On jedynie skałą i zbawieniem moim, twierdzą moją, więc się nie zachwieje. Spocznij jedynie w Bogu, duszo moja, bo od Niego pochodzi moja nadzieja. Oto Słowo Boże.
So we have had all the readings in French, English, German, Spanish, Portuguese, Arabic, and Polish. And now the Holy Father is preparing to present his catechesis, his teaching for today's general audience on discernment, focusing today on consolation.
Cari fratelli e sorelle,
dear brothers and sisters, good morning. We continue on catechesis on discernment of the Spirit. As I say, this is something that happens in our hearts. Having considered several aspects of desolation, today let us talk about consolation, another important element of the Spirit, which is not it's an important element in discernment, which is not to be taken for granted because it can lend itself to misunderstanding, understanding what is consolation, as we tried to understand last time what was desolation all about. What is spiritual consolation? It is a profound experience of interior joy consisting in seeing God's presence in everything. It strengthens faith and hope, and even the ability of doing good. The person who experiences consolation never gives up in the face of difficulties because he or she always experiences a peace that is stronger than any trial. It is therefore a tremendous gift for the spiritual life as well as life in general. Living this joy inside. Consolation is an interior movement that touches our depths. It is not flashy, not soft, but it is not flashy but soft, delicate, like a drop of water on a sponge. The person feels enveloped in God's presence in a way that always respects his or her own freedom. It is never something out of tune that tries to force itself on our will. Neither is it a passing of euphoria. On the contrary, as we have seen, even the suffering caused, for example, by our sins can become a reason for consolation. Let us recall the experience of St. Augustine when he spoke with his mother Monica about the beauty of eternal life, or the perfect joy of St. Francis that was associated with difficult situations he had to bear. Let us think of the many saints who were able to do great things, not because they thought they were magnificent or capable, but because they had been conquered by the peaceful sweetness of God's love. This is the peace that St. Ignatius discovered in himself with such amazement when he would read the lives of the saints. Everything seems put together by God inside ourselves. This is the peace that Edith Stein felt after her conversion. A year after she received baptism, she wrote, Edith Stein says, "As I abandon myself to this feeling, little by little, a new life begins to fill me and without any pressure on my will to drive me towards new realizations. This living inpouring seems to spring from an activity and it gives a strength that is not mine, which, without doing me any violence, becomes active in me. It is a genuine peace that gives rise to good sentiments inside. Above all, consolation affects hope and reaches out towards the future, puts us on a journey, allows us to take the initiative that had always been postponed. Or as you can imagine, such as baptism for Edelstein was. It is a peace that draws you towards the Lord and makes you do good things. When we are in a state of consolation, we want to do a lot of good. When we are in moments of desolation, on the contrary, we want to close ourselves inside. Consolation pushes you forward towards the service of others, the society, people. Spiritual consolation is not piloted. You cannot say to yourself, now I'll have consolation. It's not something piloted. It cannot be programmed at will. It is a gift of the Holy Spirit. It allows a familiarity with God that seems to cancel distances. When she visited the Basilica of Santa Croce in Jerusalem in Rome at the age of 14, centuries of the child Jesus tried to touch the nail venerated there. One of the nails with which Jesus was crucified, Teresa understood her daring as a transport of love and confidence. Later she would write, I truly was too audacious, but the Lord sees the depths of our hearts. He knows my intention was pure. I acted with him as a child who believes everything is permissible and who considers the Father's treasures their own. This is what St. Teresa wrote in her autobiography. The consolation makes you spontaneous, like children are spontaneous. And the consolation gives you that kind of peace and makes you spontaneous. A 14-year-old girl gives us a splendid description of spiritual consolation. We can feel a sense of tenderness towards God that makes us audacious in our desire to participate in his own life, to do what is pleasing to him, because we feel familiar with him. We feel that his house is our house. We feel welcome, loved, restored. With this consolation, we do not give up in the face of difficulty. In fact, with the same boldness, Therese would risk the Pope for permission to enter Carmel, even though she was too young and her wish was granted. What does this mean? It means that consolation makes us audacious. When we are in darkness and desolation, we feel we are not able to do anything. We are down. Desolation brings us down. Everything is dark. I can't do this. I can't do anything. Yet, during consolation, we feel we can do everything. Are you sure you can do this? Yes. I go straight. I go forward. This is what consolation does. It pushes us to go forward, to do things that we cannot do in desolation. That is the beauty of consolation. But let us be careful. We must distinguish the consolation that is of God and false consolation. Something similar happens in the spiritual life that happens in human productions. They are originals and they are imitations. An authentic consolation is like a drop on a sponge, is soft and intimate. Its imitations are noisier, are flashier, like straw fires, lacking substance. They lead us to close in ourselves and not to take care of others. In the end, false consolation leaves us empty, far from the center of our existence. When we feel happy and at peace, and we are able to do everything, but let us be able to distinguish between false consolation and that which is not. This is why we have to discern even when we feel consoled. False consolation can become a danger if we seek it obsessively as an end in itself, forgetting the Lord. As Saint Bernard would say, this is like seeking the consolation of God rather than the God of consolation. It's better to look for the Lord, and the Lord with his presence will console us and make us go forward. It's God who brings us this consolation. This is the dynamic of the child whom we spoke about last time, who looks for his or her parents only to get something, but doesn't look for them. We look for papa, we look for mom, just because we want something from them. And when the family is divided, and the children will look here and there, those are interests, that's not consolation. And we are at risk to live this consolation as infants do, we too run the risk of living our relationship with God in a childish way, of reducing it to an object that we use and consume, losing the most beautiful gift, which is Himself. Let us know to distinguish when it is consolation from God, which gives us true, deep interest. And we distinguish that from just enthusiasm that is passing. Thank you. Holy Father Pope Francis speaking about consolation in his teaching on discernment today. And now, having listened to the Holy Father's catechesis, we will now hear the summaries and the greetings in the various languages, beginning with French. The summary of the Pope's teaching in French.
Nous chanterons le Notre Père en latin. Puis, le Saint-Père donnera la bénédiction apostolique. Il l'accorde spécialement aux enfants, aux personnes âgées et aux personnes qui souffrent. Il bénira également les chapelets et les autres objets de dévotion que vous avez apportés à cette intention. Voici un résumé en français de la catéchèse que vient de prononcer le Saint-Père. Chers frères et sœurs, après avoir traité de la désolation, nous parlons aujourd'hui de la consolation, qui est un autre élément important pour le discernement. La consolation spirituelle est une expérience profonde de joie intérieure qui permet de voir la présence de Dieu en toute chose. Elle est un grand don pour la vie spirituelle et pour la vie dans son ensemble. La consolation est aussi un mouvement intime qui nous touche au plus profond de nous-mêmes. Ce n'est pas quelque chose qui essaye de forcer notre volonté, ni une euphorie passagère. Elle est liée avant tout avec l'espérance tournée vers l'avenir. La consolation spirituelle n'est pas programmable à volonté. Elle est un don de l'Esprit-Saint permettant une familiarité avec Dieu. Il y a cependant de fausses consolations qui poussent à se replier sur soi et à ne pas prendre soin des autres. La fausse consolation finit par nous laisser vides et loin du centre de notre existence. C'est pourquoi il faut faire preuve de discernement même lorsque nous nous sentons consolés. La fausse consolation peut devenir un danger si nous la recherchons comme une fin en soi, de manière obsessionnelle, en oubliant le Seigneur, c'est-à-dire en recherchant les consolations de Dieu et non le Dieu des consolations, qui est le don le plus beau. Maintenant, le Saint-Père va saluer en italien les fidèles de langue française.
Saluto cordialmente le persone di lingua francese
particolari pellegrini delle diocesi di Troyes e di Lyon, l'Istituto Stanislao di San Raffaele e l'Istituzione Nostra Signora de Sannò. Fratelli e sorelle, impariamo a lasciarci guidare ogni giorno dalle emozioni dello Spirito Santo, così potremo gustare la dolcezza pacificante dell'amore di Dio nelle difficoltà della nostra vita. Dio vi benedica.
Holy Father, now greeting the French speakers in the audience. I cordially greet the French-speaking people, especially the pilgrims from the diocese of Troyes and Lyon, the Stanislas Institute of Saint Raphael, and the Institute Notre Dame de Sannois. Brothers and sisters, let us learn to let ourselves be guided daily by the promptings of the Holy Spirit, so that we may taste the soothing sweetness of God's love in the struggles of our lives. God bless you. Holy Father, Pope Francis greeting the French pilgrims.
Most Holy Father, the English-speaking visitors and pilgrims present today wish to express to you their sentiments of respect and esteem and to assure you of their prayers for your ministry as the successor of Peter. At the end of the audience, we will sing together the Our Father in Latin. His Holiness will then impart his apostolic blessing, which he extends in a particular way to the members of your families at home. He also intends to bless any religious articles you may have brought for this purpose, and in a particular way, his blessing goes to your children, the elderly, and those who are sick. The following is a summary of the Holy Father's catechesis at the beginning of the audience. Dear brothers and sisters, in our continuing catechesis on discernment, we now consider the experience of spiritual consolation, that sense of deep inner joy, a gift of the Holy Spirit, which enables us to sense God's comforting presence and providential care in all things, even in moments of trial and difficulty. Saint Ignatius compares this grace-filled movement of the heart to a drop of water on a sponge. Quietly and in full respect for our freedom, the Lord confirms us in faith and hope and confident trust in his undying love. In the lives of great saints like Ignatius, Edith Stein, and Therese of Lisieux, we see how experiences of spiritual consolation not only bring profound interior peace and conviction, but also grant the strength to accomplish extraordinary things in God's service. The sign of an authentic consolation is precisely the serene, fruitful, and lasting peace that it brings. Discernment is needed to distinguish true consolations from those that are false, shallow, and self-indulgent. In our spiritual journey, may we always heed the sound advice of Saint Bernard, who urges us to seek the consolations of God and not the God of consolations. The Holy Father will now greet us in Italian.
Do il benvenuto a tutti i pellegrini di lingua inglese presenti all'odierno dia, specialmente a quelli provenienti dal Regno Unito e dagli Stati Uniti d'America. Su tutti voi invoco la gioia e la pace di Cristo nostro Signore.
I greet the English-speaking pilgrims taking part in today's audience, especially those from the United Kingdom and the United States of America. Upon all of you, I invoke the joy and peace of Christ our Lord.
Heiliger Vater, die Gläubigen deutscher Sprache möchten Ihnen ihre herzliche Zuneigung und aufrichtige Verbundenheit bekunden und versichern Sie zugleich Ihres Gebetes in allen Anliegen Ihres universalen apostolischen Dienstes. Zum Schluss dieser Audienz singen wir gemeinsam das Vaterunser in lateinischer Sprache. Danach wird der Heilige Vater den apostolischen Segen erteilen. Gern schließt er darin ihre Angehörigen ein, besonders die Kinder, die älteren Menschen und die Leidenden. Er segnet auch die Rosenkränze und die übrigen Andachtsgegenstände, die Sie dafür mitgebracht haben. Es folgt nun eine Zusammenfassung der Katechese des Heiligen Vaters in deutscher Sprache. Liebe Brüder und Schwestern, im Zuge unserer Katechesen über die geistliche Unterscheidung befassen wir uns heute mit der Erfahrung des Trostes, jener tiefen Freude, die uns Gottes Gegenwart in allen Dingen erkennen lässt, die in uns den Glauben und die Hoffnung stärkt und uns mit einem Frieden erfüllt, der alle Anfechtung standhalten kann. Dieser geistliche Trost ist nicht planbar oder machbar, denn er ist wesentlich eine Gabe des Heiligen Geistes, die uns in eine innige Vertrautheit mit Gott bringt. Die heilige Thérèse von Lisieux beschreibt diesen Zustand der Seele als ein Gefühl der Zärtlichkeit Gott gegenüber, der uns ermutigt und den Wunsch in uns weckt, an seinem Leben teilzunehmen, seinen Willen zu tun und uns bei ihm ganz zu Hause zu fühlen. Es gibt aber auch falsche Tröstungen. Während echte Tröstung die Seele mild, leicht und sanft wie ein Wassertropfen berührt, der in einen Schwamm eintritt, innerlich seine Wirkung entfaltet und unsere Sehnsucht nach Gott vertieft, sind die falschen Tröstungen laut und aufdringlich, aber nicht von Bestand. Diese Art des Trostes, der um seiner selbst willen gesucht wird, führt in die Selbstbezogenheit. Er hinterlässt innere Leere, weil er nicht zum Herrn führt, dem wahren und eigentlichen Quell unserer Freude. Der Heilige Vater richtet nun einen kurzen Gruß auf Italienisch an die deutschsprachigen Gläubigen.
And now the Holy Father will greet the German speakers.
Dai Santi possiamo imparare come accogliere in noi la vicinanza e l'amore di Dio. Seguendo il loro esempio, lasciamo risplendere la presenza del Signore nella nostra vita, affinché la nostra lode possa un giorno unirsi al coro degli eletti nella Gerusalemme celeste.
Der Heilige Vater hat gesagt, liebe Brüder,
dear brothers and sisters of the German language, from the saints we learn how to receive God's presence and love within us. Let us follow their example and let the presence of the Lord shine in our lives so that our praise may one day unite with the choir of saints in the heavenly Jerusalem. The Pope himself, being a Spanish speaker, will give the summary of the catechesis.
Santo Padre, los visitantes y peregrinos de lengua española que participan en esta audiencia desean manifestarle cordialmente sus sentimientos de filial afecto que acompañan con fervientes oraciones por sus intenciones de pastor de toda la Iglesia. Al final de este encuentro se cantará el Padre Nuestro en latín, después su Santidad impartirá a todos los presentes la bendición apostólica que extiende complacido a sus familiares, especialmente a los niños y a los ancianos, a los enfermos y a cuantos sufren. Bendice también los rosarios y objetos de devoción que los peregrinos llevan consigo.
Queridos hermanos y hermanas, en nuestra catequesis sobre el discernimiento hemos hablado anteriormente de la desolación. Hoy reflexionamos sobre otro elemento importante, la consolación. La consolación espiritual es un don del Espíritu Santo que nos hace experimentar la presencia de Dios en nuestro interior. Nos da alegría y nos da paz, y y refuerza en nosotros la fe, la esperanza y el deseo de hacer el bien. También nos da la fortaleza en los momentos de prueba y nos impulsa a buscar a Dios sobre todas las cosas. El discernimiento nos ayuda a distinguir la consolación auténtica de otras falsas consolaciones que en realidad nos alejan de Dios y nos dejan vacíos. La vida de los santos nos brinda hermosos ejemplos de verdadera consolación espiritual. Su secreto fue abandonarse con confianza en las manos de Dios y dejarle que sea Él quien haga su obra en ellos y por medio de ellos. Los santos nos enseñan que lo esencial en nuestra vida no es buscar los consuelos de Dios, sino al Dios de los consuelos. Saludo cordialmente a los peregrinos.
And now the Holy Father greeting. I cordially greet the Spanish speakers and also some Mexicans here. This coming Sunday, we begin the season of Advent. Let us ask the Lord to help us keep the lamp of faith burning in our lives so that we may be prepared to receive His coming, which fills us with peace and joy. May the Lord bless you, and may the Blessed Virgin watch over you. Thank you very much.
Santo Padre, os fiéis de língua portuguesa desejam testemunhar-lhe filial afeto e sincera fidelidade e rezam por todas as intenções do seu ministério apostólico universal. No final da audiência, cantaremos a oração do Pai Nosso em latim. Depois, o Santo Padre concederá a bênção apostólica, com um pensamento especial às crianças, aos idosos e aos doentes. Abençoará também os terços e demais objetos de devoção que cada um tiver consigo. Leia agora um resumo da catequese que o Santo Padre acaba de pronunciar. Outro elemento do discernimento é a consolação. Trata-se de uma experiência profunda de alegria interior, tão suave e delicada como uma gota de água que cai numa esponja, mas tão audaz que não se rende às dificuldades, porque faz sentir uma paz mais forte do que a prova. A pessoa sente-se de tal modo envolvida pela presença de Deus que até a dor dos próprios pecados pode tornar-se motivo de consolação. E porque a consolação está unida à esperança, faz-nos pôr em ação iniciativas continuamente adiadas ou nem sequer vislumbradas. É de fato um dom do Espírito Santo que nos permite gozar de uma profunda familiaridade com Deus, como se vivêssemos em sua casa. Santa Teresa do Menino Jesus, quando visitou Roma aos 14 anos, ao ver um dos cravos a paixão do Senhor, queria tocá-lo. Depois, dando-se conta da audácia, desculpava-se dizendo: comportava-me como uma criança que pensa que tudo lhe é permitido, considerando os tesouros do Pai como seus. Mas há também consolações que podem ser falsas, por isso é importante o discernimento para distinguir as verdadeiras consolações daquelas que nos fecham em nós mesmos, levando-nos a ser indiferentes para com o próximo e afastando-nos de Deus. Não esqueçamos que para encontrar as consolações de Deus, é preciso procurar primeiro o Deus das consolações. Agora o Santo Padre saúda em italiano os peregrinos e ouvintes de língua portuguesa.
Rivolgo un cordiale benvenuto ai pellegrini di lingua portoghese, in particolare a quanti vengono dal Portogallo e dalla diocesi di Chapecó, Brasile. Domenica scorsa si è celebrata nelle diocesi la giornata mondiale della gioventù, con il pensiero rivolto all'incontro dei giovani che si terrà a Lisbona nel prossimo anno. La gioia di ritrovarci e la volontà di essere insieme sono segni fondamentali per il mondo di oggi, straziato dagli scontri e dalle guerre. La Madonna custodisca il nostro desiderio di comunione e di pace. Dio benedica.
Eis a tradução das suas palavras.
I extend a cordial welcome to Portuguese-speaking pilgrims, especially those from Portugal, the Diocese of Chapecó in Brazil. Last Sunday, World Youth Day was celebrated in the various dioceses, with thoughts turned to World Youth Day, which will be held in Lisbon next year. The joy of coming together again and the desire to be together are fundamental signs of today's world torn by clashes and wars. May Our Lady protect our desire for communion and peace. God bless you.
أيها الأب الأقدس، يسر المؤمنين الناطقين باللغة العربية الحاضرين هنا أن يعبروا لكم عن مشاعر الاحترام والتقدير وشكرهم البنوي، ويرفقونها بصلواتهم الدائمة إلى الله من أجل قداستكم وخدمتكم كخليفة القديس بطرس. في نهاية هذه المقابلة سنرتل معاً صلاة الأبانا باللغة اللاتينية، ثم سيمنح الأب الأقدس جميع الحاضرين البركة الرسولية ويشمل بها جميع أحبائكم، وخاصة الأطفال والمتزوجين حديثاً والمسنين والمرضى والمتألمين بآلام شديدة، وسيبارك كذلك المسابح والأشياء التقوية التي يحملها معه كل واحد منكم. إليكم ملخص التعليم المسيحي لقداسة البابا فرانسيس. تكلم قداسة البابا اليوم على عنصر آخر من عناصر التمييز، وهو التعزية الروحية، وقال: التعزية الروحية هي خبرة فرح داخلي عميقة تساعدنا على أن نرى حضور الله في كل شيء، وهي تقوي الإيمان والرجاء فينا وتمنحنا القدرة على أن نصنع الخير. فالشخص الذي يختبر هذه التعزية لا يستسلم أمام الصعوبات، لأنه يختبر سلاماً أقوى من المحنة. لذلك فهي عطية كبيرة للحياة الروحية وللحياة ككل. بهذه التعزية يشعر الإنسان أنه محاط بحضور الله بطريقة تحترم دائماً حريته. والتعزية الروحية هي عطية من الروح القدس، بها نشعر بإحساس من الحنان تجاه الله يجعلنا جريئين، فنريد أن نشاركه في حياته نفسها وأن نعمل ما يرضيه، لأننا نشعر بأننا في ألفة معه، وهو يرحب بنا ويحبنا ويمنحنا الراحة. وقال قداسته: لكن هناك أيضاً تعزيات مزيفة، وهي ضجيج وبريق ومثل نار القش، تذهب سريعاً وتنطوي على نفسها ولا تهتم بالآخرين، وتتركنا فارغين وبعيدين عن مركز حياتنا. لهذا يجب علينا أن نميز حتى عندما نشعر بالتعزية، لأن التعزية المزيفة يمكن أن تصير خطراً إن سعينا إليها على أنها غاية في حد ذاتها وبطريقة مهووسة، ونسينا الرب يسوع. كما قال القديس برنارد: نبحث عن تعزيات الله ولا نبحث عن إله التعزيات. والآن تحية البابا باللغة الإيطالية لأبناء الشرق الناطقين اللغة العربية.
Saluto i fedeli di lingua araba. La consolazione del Signore non è inganno, nemmeno anestesia, ma è veritiera, è vicina e ci apre le porte della speranza. Il Signore vi benedica tutti e vi protegga sempre da ogni male.
I greet the Arabic speaking faithful. The consolation of the Lord is not deception or even anesthesia, but it is truthful, it is near, it opens to us the doors of hope. May the Lord bless you all and protect you always from all evil.
Ojcze Święty, pielgrzymi z Polski i z innych krajów pragną przekazać Waszej Świątobliwości wyrazy synowskiego oddania i szczerej wierności, zapewniając o modlitwie we wszystkich intencjach Jego apostolskiej posługi. Na zakończenie audiencji zaśpiewamy modlitwę Ojcze Nasz po łacinie. Po jej zakończeniu Ojciec Święty udzieli apostolskiego błogosławieństwa, obejmując nim szczególnie dzieci, osoby w podeszłym wieku i dotknięte cierpieniem. Pobłogosławi także różańce i dewocjonalia, jakie pielgrzymi przynoszą ze sobą. Oto streszczenie katechezy Ojca Świętego. W ramach cyklu katechez o rozeznawaniu podejmujemy dziś temat duchowej pociechy. Jest ona głębokim doświadczeniem wewnętrznej radości, która pozwala dostrzec obecność Boga we wszystkich rzeczach. Umacnia wiarę i nadzieję oraz zdolność do czynienia dobra. Osoba, która doświadcza pociechy, nie poddaje się w obliczu trudności, ponieważ doświadcza pokoju, który jest silniejszy od próby. Pociecha nie jest efektowna, lecz łagodna i delikatna. Czujemy się otoczeni obecnością Boga i to w sposób, który zawsze szanuje naszą wolność. Świadectwa takiej pociechy widzimy w pismach mistrzów duchowych. Święty Augustyn doświadcza jej, kiedy wraz ze swą matką, świętą Moniką, rozmyśla o pięknie życia wiecznego. Święty Ignacy zaznał jej, gdy czytał żywoty świętych. Edyta Stein doświadczyła jej po swoim nawróceniu. A święta Teresa od Dzieciątka Jezus podczas pobytu w Rzymie. I to właśnie ona daje nam wspaniały opis pociechy duchowej. Zaznajemy czułości względem Boga, która sprawia, że człowiek staje się odważny w pragnieniu uczestniczenia w Jego życiu, czynienia tego, co jest Mu miłe. Pocieszenia duchowego nie da się zaprogramować. Jest ono darem Ducha Świętego. Niestety istnieją też pocieszenia fałszywe. Są one hałaśliwe i rzucają się w oczy. Koncentrują człowieka na samym sobie. Dlatego również pociechy trzeba rozeznawać. Pociecha nie może być celem sama w sobie, bo wtedy, jak powiedziałby święty Bernard, szukalibyśmy Bożych pocieszeń, ale nie Boga, który te pocieszenia daje. Teraz Ojciec Święty pozdrowi nas Polaków w języku włoskim.
Saluto cordialmente tutti Polacchi. Vi sono grato perché in questi giorni vi siete uniti con i cristiani perseguitati nel mondo partecipando all'iniziativa del Red Week e pregando per loro in modo particolare nel santuario di Jasna Gloria. La Madre di Dio conceda loro la piena libertà e consolazione nella sofferenza. Vi benedico di cuore.
Oto słowa Ojca Świętego. Pozdrawiam.
I cordially greet all Polish people. I am grateful that in these days you have been united with persecuted Christians around the world by participating in the Red Week initiative and praying for them in a special way at the Shrine of Jasna Góra. May the Mother of God grant them full freedom and consolation in their suffering. I bless you from my heart.
Santo Padre, i fedeli di lingua italiana desiderano esprimerle filiale affetto e sincera fedeltà e pregano per tutte le intenzioni del suo universale ministero apostolico. A conclusione di questa udienza canteremo la preghiera del Padre Nostro in latino, terminata la quale il Santo Padre impartirà la benedizione apostolica che estende in modo speciale ai bambini, agli anziani e ai sofferenti. Benedirà anche i rosari e gli oggetti di devozione che ciascuno porta con sé.
And finally, the Holy Father will exchange greetings with the Italian-speaking pilgrims. In recent hours in Java, there has been an earthquake. I wish to extend my closeness to all those who have died because of this earthquake in Indonesia and to those who are injured. And last week, a new blessed of the Church, Joseph Ambrosoli, was beatified in Uganda. He was a medical doctor and a priest. That his testimony will help us all to be. Let us give an applause for the new beatified in Uganda, Joseph Ambrosoli. I want to extend my greetings to the players and the fans from various worlds who are participating in Qatar at the World Cup football event. That this World Cup will help bring about harmony in the world. With a special thought for the people of Ukraine. Let us think of the martyred people of Ukraine. This Saturday, there will be also an anniversary of the people who died as a result of the genocide that was perpetrated by Stalin. We pray for those who suffer the martyrdom of aggression. Also, the Pope making reference to the World Day for the Week for fishermen, that their work will help nourish the world. I extend a cordial welcome to Italian-speaking pilgrims. In particular, I greet representatives of the Fedei Catholic schools and hope their remarkable educational and social contribution will be acknowledged at all levels. I extend my greetings to the Association NOI of oratories and parishes and parish circles, encouraging them to continue their fruitful and valuable work in the service of evangelization and human promotion. Finally, my thoughts go as usual to the young, the sick, the elderly, and the newlyweds. This coming Sunday will mark the beginning of Advent, the liturgical season that proceeds and prepares us for the celebration of a blessed Christmas. I wish each of you to open your hearts to the Lord. Please open your hearts to the Lord to prepare the way for the one who comes to fill our human weaknesses with the light of his presence. To all of you, my blessings. The Holy Father, they are making some quick appeals for Indonesia. We know that 268 people have died as a result of earthquake in Indonesia. And now we recite the Our Father together.
Domino Hobiscum. Sit nomen Domini Benedictum. Aiuterium nostrum in nomine Domini. Benedicat vos omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus.
There we have it, the apostolic blessing from the Holy Father, our Pope Francis. On this Wednesday general audience, interesting also towards the end, the Holy Father wishing that the World Cup taking place in Qatar will be a catalyst for world peace. With that papal blessing, we have now come to the end of today's live broadcast of Pope Francis's weekly general audience from St. Peter's Square. I'm Father Paul Samasumo, and it has been a privilege for me to provide you with the English language commentary for this Wednesday general audience of Pope Francis. We will leave you now with these pictures of the bishops that you are seeing filing to greet the Holy Father, bishops from all over the world. The Pope will later also greet some of the newlyweds that are in the square and other pilgrims that are here in St. Peter's Square. All the summaries of today's teachings by Pope Francis, the appeals he has made towards the end, you will find on our website, vaticannews.va. On behalf of Vatican Media, enjoy the rest of your day. Laudato Jesus Christus. Praise be Jesus Christ.